Using this forceps to hold the various parts, and you can also use the hand lens as it may require, as the question may demand. So we are going to go straight into pinning the guinea pig. So when you are pinning the guinea pig, it is advisable to give some space on the board, preferably to the right, and then you pin it slightly towards the left. So we are going to pin our guinea pigs onto our board. So pin on faster. So this is how we pin it. It's very important. Pinning the guinea pig is very important. So we make sure that it is tough. We press it down, drag it down, and this is tough. So we pin it onto the board as such. So after pinning it onto the board, what will be required to do is that some people may be tempted to be shaving the abdominal region so that they will have a clean area where to bisect. But shaving is a method, but it takes quite a long time. So what is advisable to do is to use water. You soak up a tissue paper or cotton wool and you draw the water on to the abdominal region. So when you make water there, you will make the hair to lie flat. The hair lies flat like that, and you realize that your guinea pig is ready for dissection. This don't take any much time. Doesn't take any much time, and your guinea pig is ready for dissection. So after doing it, you take a pair of forceps. Take a pair of forceps, and using your left hand, you hold the tissue in the abdomen, using the pair of forceps, you hold the abdominal tissue like that, and then you make an incision. You hold it, you make an incision by cutting that abdominal tissue like that. That's the first incision you make. So when you make this incision now, you will be required to use a probe from your dissecting set. You use a blunt end probe. This is what is called a probe, and the ending is blunt. So you use this probe and you put it inside the incision that you have made. Because you see that the abdomen is made of two walls. So when you put it inside, you use this other scissors that has one end which is bluntly ended and another end which is sharp. So you hold it in the way that the blunt edge is going to go inside and the sharp edge remains outside. So when you hold it, you then cut a straight line up there. The probe is there directing you where you should go, and then the blunt end of the scissors is coming and cutting it, but without destroying the tissues inside. So you cut it right up to the neck region of your guinea pig. So you cut it up even to the mouth. It's advisable to cut it up right to the lower part of the mouth. So we cut at the right to the lower part of the mouth. Cut to the lower part. And then we do not move about. What we do is we simply turn our animal. We turn it this way. We turn the board. And then we also cut down towards the anal region. When we reach there, we stop. We turn it slightly again, and then we cut towards the limbs. We cut it towards the limbs, still using our prop like that. And we cut this one also towards the limbs. So cut towards the limbs, we turn it up this way again. We also cut it towards the limbs. So cut like that. We cut it like that towards the limbs.
1 minute.
To open up the skin. So open up the skin like that. So open up the skin. And better we'll pin it onto the board. You open the skin on the two sides. You need to use some force, but not very brute force. Just have to hold the skin and not the inner tissues.
you open up, and then you pin them onto the board. Pin them onto the board. Do that thing with a hand.
Pull it. Pull it like that. Pull it like this. Pull it. You don't have time to be wasting like that. When you are doing like that, you waste so much time. And at the end, you realize that you don't have time even to draw what you have done. And that you lose many marks. This is what you do. So you do like that, you then pin it onto the board. So after pinning it, I'll make another incision again on the abdomen again. So I hold the tissue and I cut like that to expose the internal contents. So after that, I still use my prop again. I still use my prop to cut up. But this time around, I cut only up to the level of the xiphoid cartilage. This is the area of the cartilage. This is the xiphoid cartilage. So when I reach the xiphoid cartilage, I stop. I don't cut further. I remain there. So I also turn it again. Turn it again. And then I will cut down towards the anal region. Cut down like that. And I end here. And I also cut again a little bit towards the leg there. And I also cut towards this side. Then I come up now this way. I do not cut here towards the leg, but I cut down. I see the position of the ribs this way. So I cut here like that. I do not cut up. So I cut here, I come this way, and I see the position of the ribs. These are the ribs here. So I cut here, cut this way, so I don't destroy the ribs. So after cutting it now, I'll still pin this inner tissue. So I pin it again onto the board, and onto the board. I pin this one this way. Okay, having pinned this and opened the abdominal cavity, this organism now is described as the abdominal contents of the guinea pig in situ. So if you were to display the internal abdominal contents in situ, you just open them like that and leave it like that, and then draw a diagram like that. So this is the first stage, which is exposing the abdominal contents in situ of the guinea pig. So these people are still. So I turn it, but as these contents are in situ, what I have to do is to be able to identify the parts that are there. We should always remember to wet our dissections. If the dissection is not wet, it will become dry, and the parts, you may cut the parts or you may not see the parts well. So with this part in situ, I can be able to identify a number of parts here. This one is obvious. This is the bladder here that contains urine. This is the bladder here with urine. Very certain. This is the large intestine, as large as it looks. It's a large intestine. And then we have here, this is another part of the large intestine. This should be the ascending and the lateral colon. And then this is the small intestines, or the ileum. This way, this is ileum. And then here I have the liver, I have the liver lobes. These are the liver lobes. This is the left loop, and this is the right loop. And then this one is the spleen. The one that I see here is the spleen. And then these are the ribs. This is what I can see in situ. These ones are the muscles of the muscular, of the abdomen that protect the internal abdominal contents. So,
This is the same thing that we are seeing here. The various parts in situ, you can still see the bladder here, but already you can see the testis here. This one is the testis. This one is the male, this is the testis. So this is the large intestine, small intestine. Then you can have the stomach right up this way, the Z4 cartilage, then these are the ribs.